like my sister Belinda and all of you, I want to thank you for what you do. Your passion and your commitment to the best education system possible. The fact that you feel this with all your emotion and energy. You do what you do, not to get rich, because you want a system of educational excellence that takes care of our children, that provides for our state. Now, there are some in Sacramento who would attempt to exploit your passion, and they will feel that it's okay to furlough you, or it's okay to contract out services, or it's okay to continuously cut your budget and attempt to balance the state deficit on the back of schools, but it is not okay. It is not fine. And some who will come before you and say, I am with you, I stand with you, they'll fill out your 30-page questionnaire, and they'll get every question right. And your boards will endorse, and they'll run for office, whether Democrats or Republicans. But when it becomes crunch time, whether or not they'll protect your job, whether you have the resources necessary to do what you passionately believe must happen in the best interest of our golden state, they're not there. I think it's not good enough. It's not good enough. There has to be a new paradigm. You have to know how to say no. You have to tell those who are making the decision, if you can't push the green light in support of us, then we will not check the ballot box next to your name.
Yay! Woo!
Dave Lowe, who is an outstanding representative for you in Sacramento. You give Dave another round of applause. And I'm not just saying that because I'm jealous, because I can't grow, you know, the long. If I had a ponytail, you know. But he is an outstanding representative, and you are well represented in Sacramento. That's not the problem. It's not that these presentations have not been made to legislators. You have nothing to apologize for. I honor you because of the work you do for us. If we were telling the truth, we will not survive this recession unless you have the resources to help train the workforce that can get out and do the job that we need done in the state of California. You cannot come out of this economic downturn without education, without an educational system that is strong and vibrant and delivers, without proper training, without a partnership with the Obama administration that has gone out of its way to say, let's save all the jobs we can. We will give you money to do that, but no, there are those that want to backfill the state budget.
Yeah.
And waste this partnership. I'll tell you that there is no budget crisis in the state of California. There's a crisis of leadership.
Yay! Yay!
Simple majority budget. We must pass it. We must take this dysfunctional system that exists in the state of California and turn it on its head. Our children deserve that. We deserve that. The good news is that we live in a democracy. And the good news is next year's election year.
Yay! Yay!
And I've been in politics for 35 years, and I understand that now they're going to start coming to this podium and speaking to you, and they're going to ask you for your support, and you're going to sit there like this, and you're going to listen to every word. And you're going to ask them if they're going to stand with you. Just as those that signed pledges that said they would not raise taxes to support schools, they would not raise revenue to support police officers, nurses, they would not raise revenues under any circumstance, then some of them have to come before you like I come before you and say, I am a state legislator. I will not vote to cancel out your contracts or cut your budget. I will promise you that. You have to do it with someone else's vote. Or perhaps those items in the budget represent the priorities that this state needs to fight for. And don't say it can't happen. When it was proposed last week or 2 weeks ago that they do offshore drilling, the legislator came together and said no. There was a solid no vote. You deserve some of those no votes. And so they're coming forward next year. And as a longtime activist, I will tell you that it's high time.
Yeah.
Dave Lowe talked about it one way. Let me talk about it another way. Election time is time for a little street heat.
Yeah.
It's time for a little street heat.
Yay! Yay!
You elect people that stand with you, and you elect them with what? Street heat.
Yay!
You stand with a governor that's going to be out there campaigning for you and that will vote for you. You elect that governor by bringing street heat.
Yay!
Those candidates, Democrats, Republicans, it doesn't matter. Will they stand with you? Will they stand with our children? I will tell you, I'm in the cloakrooms, I hear the conversations, and I know that they will respect you if you demand that respect.
Yay! Yay! Respect!
From the bottom of my heart, I thank you for what you do for our children and our state. From the bottom of my heart, I will always stand with you. I share your passion and your love for our children. God bless.
Yay!